are here.
Finally.
I have delivered you safe to our final destination for Tides of Change. And where are we?
Shanghai. We've been driving for 2 weeks, over two weeks. Now we finally arrived at our final stop, Shanghai.
Yeah, and before that, I need to get my phone in the car because you can't drive with your phone, so I left it in the car. Sorry, guys.
So, this is my co-host, Angela. I'm Jingjing. We're both from CGTN. So, for the past 2 weeks, our Tides of Change team have been showing wonderful stories in different cities in southern China, and today we arrived in Shanghai. But Shanghai is a little bit... The story we're going to show you today is a little bit from the stories you heard about Shanghai before.
I mean, we can see around us. When we talk about Shanghai, we probably think about the nightlife, the metropolis, the skyscrapers. But today, it's actually very quiet and serene. It's because this is where we have a very important job here in Shanghai, where we protect the ecosystem, the marine life, and everything that lives along the Yangtze economic belt of the river.
Many people don't know Shanghai is the crucial place to protect marine life because it's the end of Yangtze River, the most important river in China. So there are a lot of fish and marine life living in this region. So today, the region, tell all the viewers what this place is about.
So we are here at the Shanghai Aquatic Wildlife Conservation and Research Center because inside the Yangtze River, there's a very special creature that lives within it. And today, you guys are very lucky because we will actually show you. We'll go up close and personal with this amazing creature.
Yes, it's known as Chinese sturgeon. There are so many different kinds of sturgeons around the world. Yeah. But today, we're going to tell you, introduce you, let you get a close look at this special Chinese sturgeon. And to tell us more about it, we have a special guest.
So he'll have Zheng Yueping, the Vice Director of this amazing Conservation Research Center. So, without further ado, we can...
Okay.
So, this looks like a really huge and nice pavilion.
But my eyes have been caught, especially if I camera... That's where I'm heading to.
Ta-da! Chinese sturgeon right in front of the tank.
This is huge. So we'll have the expert explain what we have in this. Oh, there's a lot of different fish. So, Zhengzhu, we can see a lot of different fish.
啊，对，鲟鱼还是我们这里面大家看到的有五尾，个体最大的就是我们的中华鲟，是我们国家的一级保护动物。Biggest one are the Chinese sturgeon.
Yeah, so we can see that within this tank, there's different types of fish and different types of sturgeon. But the biggest one is our main protagonist today is our Chinese sturgeon.
Yeah, look at this.
So this is our national treasure, and also right now it's critically endangered as well. So that's why it's under protection, and there's a lot of research. And we can see that we have our expert scientist there as well that looks after these amazing fish. And these are also called kings of the freshwater fish. 因为这些也是属于什么淡河水之王，淡水之王，是因为它们是我们长中华鲟的话，目前是我们长江里面。
The biggest fish in Yangtze River.
How big can they grow to? 它们最长能长多少？它可以长到五米长，体重可以达到五百公斤以上。
500 kilograms
of the, up to 5 meters long. So these are huge fish. And here we have about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 大概它们。
年龄是有的，这个里面的现在年龄的话是21岁。
This one is 21 years old.
这五尾大的都是21岁。对对。那它们现在大概有多长呢？是两米到三米？最大的个体是3米长，200公斤。
The largest one is
three meters long,
200 kilograms.
So a lot bigger than us.
你可以看到，它这个个体比我们的潜水员要大得多。
So it's a lot bigger than our scuba diver, even with his fins.
潜水员穿的脚蹼可能还没有它长。
Exactly. Even with his fins, his flippers, it's still not as long as these fish. 其实它们看着很温顺，虽然它们很大。对，因为中华鲟的话，它虽然个体很大，但是呢。
它是一个相对比较温顺的鱼，它没有一颗牙齿。
So we can see.
你看它的嘴是没有牙齿的。So
there's no teeth.
Yeah, so even though they're enormous, but they're actually very gentle creatures. So, and you can see that they don't actually have any teeth. 那它们怎么捕食呢？ How's they eat?
它的捕食的话，主要是依靠它这个吮吸，它是完全就是吞咽式的。
Swallow the whole piece, the whole fish, or whatever.
然后可以看到我们潜水员给它喂食，就可以看到它这个摄食的动作。
So later the scuba diver gonna feed all those sturgeons. 一会儿就会给它喂食，是吗？
So there's one heading towards us. We can see that they look very cute, but a lot of people mistake these really round things in their head for their eyes.
But they are just the nose.
Exactly.
And breathing holes. Mm. But their eyes are actually very small. You have to really look closely, look carefully, like the tiny beans on the side of their head. That's the eyes.
因为我们刚才也在说，就是其实我们看到很大的那个圆圈，其实是他们的鼻孔，然后不是他们的眼睛，他的眼睛在鼻孔的后面很小，
因为它是一个属于生活在水的底层的，就属于一个底栖习性的一个鱼类。那么，因为它长期的一个进化过程中间，它生活的海洋，它是海洋的底层，光线比较弱。它在长江里面的话，我们整个长江其实是水是相对比较浑浊的，它也是一个底栖习性。那么它的眼睛实际上是一个退化。但是呢，它的其他的感觉器官会比较发达。
So these fish normally lives at the bottom, so we can see that they're at the bottom of the tank right now because they eat kind of the prawns and little crabs fish at the bottom of the sea, and that's why they have very big these nostrils, which are actually sensory forms, especially their whisker as well. And we have one at the bottom. I think we can see a lot closer. And the eyes have actually kind of become.
Because they don't use the sense of vision that much at the bottom of the ocean. Just like a lot of those marine lives at the deep ocean.
Yes.
A lot of them don't even have eyes because like there's no use.
They don't need it anymore. They're so gentle and they're coordinating with us very nicely.
就是对我们还挺友好的，就是而且一直在，可能是对我们好奇。而且它有一个像胡须一样的东西，
那是它的四根须，也是它的感觉器官之一。
每只有四根吗？还是
四根？
哦，所以 they only have four whiskers, which is a sensory. So when they're basically on the seabed, they can feel 是能感觉到食物的，是吧？
对对对。
See, like they are touching the ground floor,
looking for food.
Ooh, it just parked in front of us.
Oh, this is perfect. So we can see 这个背鳍，因为它是一个没有。Technically, 没有硬骨的鱼。
对，它是个软骨鱼类。
So it's why sturgeons are very special is that they don't actually have bone plates, little bone plate, calcium plates, but inside is all cartilage, so very soft bones inside. 然后其实除了这个这么大的这个鱼，还有我看还有其他的，这小一点的也是中华鲟吗？就
是这个是我们的长江里面另外一个一级保护动物，叫长江鲟。
Yangtze sturgeon,
also a protected animal.
它主要是生活在我们长江的中上游。
So the Yangtze sturgeon lives around upper Yangtze River.
那个像帆一样的，这个叫胭脂鱼。
胭脂鱼
，That's a common sucker.
So, 胭脂鱼，这也是我们长江里面的二级保护动物。
So this is level 2 protected animal within the Yangtze River.
因为它每年的话，在四五月份，成熟季节的话非常漂亮，因为它的颜色啊，就像我们女士使用的这个口红，以前叫胭脂，都是这种颜色，所以叫胭脂鱼。
对，是吗？So maybe a few months later, we will see those tiny fish, also protected animal in this tank.
Yeah.
They got the name because they are very colorful at a certain age.
Like a blush.
Like a blush.
That's in Chinese called 胭脂鱼
blush fish.
Very elegant. And also, 这里是不是之前我看还有一种
里面还有一条其他的叫杂交鲟。你看它有在后面。
那一只。
Like the one at the back, 最后面那一只。它是一个杂交鱼
，hybrid sturgeon，
对，杂交鲟。
为什么我们叫它杂交鲟呢？
因为它是由两种不同的鲟鱼杂交而成的这个养殖品种，它是属于一个商业养殖品种，商业养殖品种。
Yeah. So we see a hybrid sturgeon. So that's not what we say maybe a pure sturgeon because that's more for commercial uses. 所以就是因为我们这些鲟都是一级纯种鲟，都是一级保护动物，对吧？
对。
所以我们其实，在市面上看到的一些鲟，如果是能食用的，其实是杂交鲟。
绝大多数都是杂交鲟，都是杂交鲟。
Yeah. So you're just saying that it's actually illegal to, but we do sometimes see like caviars or we see some sturgeon meat on the market, but most of those are made and produced. from these hybrid sturgeons. So with the right qualifications and paperwork, it is legal to consume those. But those won't be released back into the sea because they would disrupt the ecosystem.
And it's forbidden, it's totally illegal to eat caviars from Chinese sturgeon. And it's most sturgeons in the world, actually. So if you do see some restaurant with a commercial lines saying this is caviar from Chinese sturgeon, report them. Call the police. Yes.
Exactly.
They are protecting animals.
The
scuba divers bring the food for the sturgeons.
I mean, this is so amazing because we could never see this in the wild. Mm-hmm. 其实我们在野生的话根本看不到这些鱼的这种
看不到它的怎么摄食，这个看不到的。Mm-hmm. 只有在这个我们人工的环境下面才能比较清楚的能够看到。
像中华鲟的话，它的食物主要以什么为主呢？是鱼类、贝壳类还是无脊椎类？
它在野外的环境下呢，特别在海洋里面，它主要是以生活在海洋底层的这种底栖的生物，包括有海水里面的虾还有这个蟹类，比如梭子蟹这一类的还有这种比目鱼这一类，就生活在底层的对，因为比目鱼主要是生活在水的底层，而且游动速度比较慢然后还有一些这种贝类，比如说这种类似于这种蛏子消化呢，它对吃进去的鱼类那种里面的硬骨，就是我它会把它的肉啊等等可消化的则消化，另外一个消化不了的这个硬骨啊，它就会排泄出来。
那蟹子那个钳子，它也是
they have a strong digestive system.
So basically, this Chinese sturgeon live to eat those marine life live at the bottom of the sea, like some fish, some shells, some crabs.And I was wondering, because they don't have teeth, how do they chew those shells, those claws of the crabs? Basically, they don't. They have a very strong stomach.
Exactly. They just basically swallow the thing in whole, and then pass out what's not edible.
Wow.
那条鱼误认为是有吃的，它在咬潜水员的脚。去了。
It's gone in. 所以就是吞下。swallow it a whole. 所以它现在喂的是什么？我们潜水员？
现在我们给它喂的是鱼块，就是经过处理的鱼块。对。
So it's little fish chunks, fish fillet.
你看这条鱼，它在这里吃完一口，它还想吃，所以它还在绕着。
So this Chinese sturgeon wants more.
Don't eat our scuba divers. Don't. Because one already bite the fin of the scuba diver. But
he is hungry. 这个是雌性还是？
我们目前里面的四位呢都是雌性的。
All female, so it's a she. Yeah, so you're very hungry. Hungry lady.
因为这中华鲟应该也是时间生在这个地球上生活时间是非常长的，可以追溯到跟恐龙同一个时期，
对不对？
也是最早的一个无脊椎的动物。
无脊椎动物也不能这么说，但是从鲟鱼来讲的话。我们的发现的化石的话，就是它有1.4亿年以上的历史。就从它的起源来讲，这个物种在地球上出现的话，可以追溯到1.4亿年以前，它可能就在地球上存在了，那么一直延续到现在，所以它是一个比较古老的一个物种。
Longest living animals in the world, basically they were living with the dinosaurs.
Yeah, so 140 million years ago, that's the earliest fossils that we found. So I think that's kind of the late Cretaceous.Period with the dinosaurs late Jurassic time, and 那他们和以前他们的 ancestors 就他们以前的
祖先们，
长得是一样的吗？
从目前我们就是说可以看到的化石来讲的话，其实形态差别不是特别大不是特别大，而且它整个形态里面的话，相对比较原始，一个它的骨骼都是软骨的包括它的这个像它的尾也是个弯形尾。那么这些其实都是它相对比较原始的一种形态特征。
So these fish haven't gone through a lot of morphic since the 140 million years ago. So we're really looking at kind of living fossils. So because of their bone structure or lack of bone structure, the cartilage, so they haven't really changed very much since 140 million years ago.
所以就是因为他们活了这么久，其实对于我们去研究古生物也好，地球的演变也好，
对对
是有很大的价值的，
对
吧？
对，从科学上，就从生物的进化，对吧？包括地质的变迁，地球的就是从生物地理学上面等等， 是吧？而且还有一个中华鲟身上有很多很多没有解决的科学问题，比如说它的洄游机制到底是什么决定的，对吧？包括它的话在海牙里面，它到底是。我们现在知道它分布在我们国家的沿海的大陆架啊，整个沿海都有分布，但是它是先去了哪里，后去了哪里，对吧？是什么决定它去哪里的？所以这些东西都还没解决。
So they are very critical for humans to study the evolution of animals.
Our planet.
Yes, and also there are so many features about this Chinese sturgeon that humans cannot figure out.
So like why? Yeah, a lot of unanswered scientific mysteries, and that's why these research centers are so important, and why it's so important to conserve these living fossils. And one of the mysteries I think they were talking about is these fish live in the ocean, but they actually spawn and in the river. So in the Yangtze River. So they go from the sea to the river, and they grow for a while, and then they go back to the sea. I mean, that's a mystery why they do that.
Yeah.
And also we have a map here that shows basically their line, their journey.
of the Chinese sturgeon. So right now you see the blue line is the Yangtze River. And you can see different cities like in Hubei province, in Jiangsu province, in Shanghai. So basically the red arrows are where the Chinese sturgeons swim through the ocean. They will lay their eggs in the middle of the Yangtze River, and they will swim all the way in Shanghai and then enter the ocean. And they will grow in the ocean when they turn 10 years later, when they became adults, when they decided to have the next generations. They will swim back to those cities and continue to lay eggs to breed their next generations. So basically, their roots are located in Yangtze River in China, but they spend their adult years in the ocean, migrated to the ocean, and then come back after they grow old. Yeah. So it's a mystery. Why they choose to have a lifestyle like this?
So now is why they will come back to the Yangtze to...
This kind of life habit actually很少有其他的这个海洋动物和有这样的一个习性，对不对？
其实三文鱼是不是也可以算？
那个我们长江里面的洄游鱼类也不少啊，包括这里能看到的这个松江鲈鱼，它也是个洄游性的鱼类啊，但是它跟中华鲟是相反的，它是在海洋里面繁殖啊，在淡水里面成长的啊。那么像这个刀鱼、刀鲫，它也是一个洄游性的鱼类。像这个日本鳗鲡，它也是个洄游性的。
So these are all migratory fish. So they spend some part of their time in the ocean, and then some part of their time in the river. So it's a mystery why they do it. But there's a lot of fish, and these are all found in the Yangtze River as well. So this is why we can see that there's so much ecosystem, so much life within this river. I mean, Yangtze is about 6,000 kilometers, so it's definitely the ecosystem is phenomenal, and that's why we need to keep these rivers clean as well. And that's why I think at the start of this year, in March, so we have a new legislation that came into effect that was passed at the end of last year, which is the Yangtze River Protection Law. And this is the first legislation in the country that protects a specific river basin. So this is also very important to
protect 长江保护法的出台是一个非常重要的一个具有历史性意义的一个标志性的东西啊，因为这是我们中国首部以国家法律的形式为一个特定的流域制定的一个法律。
So this is a historical moment actually, because this is the first law that we've passed that is for a specific river basin. 那这个为什么这么重要呢？就保护我们的长江。
因为长江的话是我们中华民族的母亲河，长江里面有非常多的水生生物，据不完全统计的话，长江里面的鱼类就有400多种，400多种。那么现在可能有一些鱼类可能现在已经见不到了啊。那么包括长江里面水生生物的资源数量现在也下降的比较明显。那么作为我们的一个中华民族的母亲河，作为我们国家整个发展的一个非常重要的一个生态屏障的话，那么加强长江的保护是一个非常重要的、具有非常重要意义的一个事情。
Like many Chinese call the Yangtze River as the mother river for all the Chinese. So, and there were like 400 different kinds of species of marine life living in Yangtze River. So this law basically shows the Chinese people's dedication in protecting the river, the ecosystem, the environment.
Yeah, and it's very vital because this is what basically provides for our daily lives. Yeah. You might think it's very far, but honestly, when we see these majestic creatures and think that maybe in the future, mm-hmm. their future is threatened, you really think about the future generation, whether or not they'll be lucky enough to see what we just witnessed. Mm-hmm. And now we're heading to an even special place.
Yes.
The nursery.
So we have some
fishing pieces. Yes, this is our entire Yangtze area.
Wow.
We can go on our Yangtze channel.
So
this particular tank is 225 meters squared, and the entire place is over 4,000 square meters. Yeah.
这个水深是 2.5 米。
And this is 2.5 meters deep.
这里面是有什么呢?
这里面你看到的鱼是我们其实主要都是养这个中华鲟的。
All Chinese sturgeons in those pools,
in the tanks.
Oh,
what just jumped?
They know people
they know
are coming.
Coming, yeah.
做什么？
这是我们就是说，这是做一个放流驯化的一个工作。 那么我们现在这个机器呢，叫涌浪机，或者也叫造浪机。造浪机主要是在这个鱼池里面给它营造一个，就是说波浪的这种复杂的环境，就是让我们这个中华鲟啊，在我们给它放归自然的时候，它能够更好的、更快的适应野外的这种复杂的环境。
This is like a wave generator. So basically, they will try to
mimic the environment
of the natural sea because, you know, there are so many waves and currents. It's very complicated living situation for all those marine lives. So they are training those Chinese sturgeons to get used to strong waves, strong currents before releasing them back to the ocean.
To the real world, basically, because they do release a lot of these sturgeons back into the ocean, hoping that they will continue to create even more
fish. That's basically just like us when we study in the universities.
Yeah.
We get workshops, different practices before, just do some tests. A taste
of the real world before it's released.
那我们这边其实也做很多的放生是吧，就是把它恢复。我们叫增殖放流，专业叫增殖放流，其实就是把我们人工培育的或者我们抢救存活的这个水生生物 再重新给它放回到自然界去，补充野外的这个群体的这个数量。这个是我们这个中华鲟的标本。这是一个中华鲟，这个是野生的标本。这是一个wild sturgeon。这是三点五米，体重是350公斤。3.5
meters and 350 kilograms. That is a heavy and big fish.
你看到野生中华鲟的它这个骨板啊，就非常的清晰，它就像武士的铠甲一样。So
we were talking earlier about the bone plates on the back. So these are really the kind of semi-hard bones that this fish have. 然后其实里面就都是软骨了，是吧？对对对。And the inside is all soft bones, it's all cartilage.
It's like they're wearing an armor.
Yeah. That's the only. 那其实就只有这些是在保护它们。这些相对来说就是它的一个硬鳞，就是比较坚硬的。 保护机制了，是吧？因为剩下的就是它的皮肤，那么皮肤相对来说也是比较厚的。所以这个鱼有天敌吗？小的时候有很多天敌，等它长大了之后呢，那它就可以成为其他鱼类的天敌。So the juvenile fish have a lot of predators that will eat them, but once they grow up, they become on the top of the food chain.
When you are like big and like this one,
when you look like this,
no one dare to mess with you.
Exactly.
We have so many specimens here.
我们就有很多的标本，是吧？你看，这是一个好大的海龟的标本，而且那一边呢会有非常多的鱼类的标本。其实我们这个地方是对外开放的吗？还是对学生们？我们这个地方呢，就是不是完全开放的一个场所，因为我们实际上是一个保护机构、保护研究机构。那么我们这些设施呢，是对这种。 比如学生啊，进行一种预约制的这种工作啊，因为我们这个地方就是说主要是做保护，然后是做科普，
So it's very special for us because this is not normally open to the public and it's only for reservation for students to learn for educational purposes. So it's very special for all of you guys as well, our viewers, that we actually get to see all of this because normally this is just a research center.
I don't know how do you feel about it because I like this place. We are both scuba divers and we love marine life, and especially when you're a scuba diver, when you go to the ocean, you will see like firsthand how the underwater world are destroyed or affected by human beings' behaviors.
You can actually see, I mean, the world, 71% of the world is covered by ocean and by the sea. So it's really important that we keep it safe. And as we're walking,
this is very much alive. 类似于有点像长江流域一些典型的一个生态环境的一个模拟的水族缸，那么这个缸里面呢，其实类似于这个山涧溪流，那么就是比如说我们的黄山，我们的神农架，我们的张家界，就有这种类似的这种环境。
So it's not just a tank. They recreate the climate or the structure of along the Yangtze River basically create the same environment for
a simulation of the Yangtze environment. And this is simulating the Shenlongjia area and also the Zhangjiajie area. And we can actually see here, this is also a very special creature. This is a giant, I don't know if our viewers can see it, this is a giant Chinese salamander. So these are also very native to China and to the Shenlongjia area. And this one I think is sleeping, so I'm worried to disturb it.
But you can see the whole size of it. Because normally if you dive into the water, you only see the head. You think it's a fat, short fish, but actually they're huge.
The rest of it is inside the cave. So with giant Chinese salamanders, they love these really, really clear river, and these can be found along the Yangtze, and also with a bit dark, so that's why it's hiding in caves. And there's a lot of these fish tanks around here.
These fish tanks are so pretty, I have to say, like the light, different species,
they're pretty.
It's like a lake.
我们这种草型的湖泊。就这些就是植物也都是来自湖泊的植物。
Even the vegetation here are the river basin.
那个就是有名的亚洲鲤，我们叫鲢鱼。中文叫鲢鱼和鳙鱼。
So you can see like a school of fish that's also native to the Yangtze River. And I think when you see this, you realize how important it is to protect, to respect our environment.
And this tiny one that are distracted by the light. So it's small, but it's not scared of anyone else.
So this is a very special kind of display. Instead of seeing just a specimen of a fish, it's really important for students to view these in real life because we don't actually get to see this.
Oh, I love this one. They're mud skippers.
In the mud, and they were jumping around, and we thought they were just jumping fish. There's more on that side, on the mud. So we see like
they're sunbathing.
You can actually see, I don't know if you can see, they're actually using their fins. So normally we see the fins, but they're using them as arms.
Do you see like all of them are bathing, sunbathing on this wood?
They're actually using their fins to kind of using them as arms and climb trees. That's incredible.
They have very big eyes. And you see like this, the whole environment of this tank. If you just look at this part, you don't think it's a tank. It's just like a natural world with all this.
When
we think that they might be amphibious because they're kind of in the water and they can live out the water, but they're still fish. They still have to live in the water.
因为它的生活环境呢，就是在一个潮间带，就我们沿海的潮间带。 它就形成了这种适应这种潮间带的这种环境的这种生活习性，包括它可以攀爬到这个没有水的这个滩地上面，对吧？也能爬到这个树桩上面，啊，这是一个。另外一个，它还能打洞，啊，它就做洞穴的功能。
So they can live in the water and they can also live on the banks. And 它不会在深海喽，就只会在。
对它，因为它就是我们属于这种。滩涂的这种生物，适应这种滩涂环境的，它不会到很深的水里面去，也不会去很干旱的这个陆地上。那么它就在这个，
就在这个
我们这个有潮汐、潮涨、潮落的这种环境下面。
So they live with the tides. So depending on the tides,
they enjoy the tides of change.
这种
that's a good one. 对，
它就是这种适应了这种环境，对。
这个颜色为什么突然间变了？
是因为这个，对，这个为什么打的是这种蓝，发一点紫的光？
这个是属于这个我们海洋里面，其实看上去都是偏蓝色的，对吧？
视觉效果。
这个呢，就是有点像我们近海的近岸
啊 ，shallow。
所以这里面有点是咸水了，是吧？
这是海水。
海水。Between the Yangtze and the ocean, so I think the fish before were all in the rivers. So these are actually.
我们从那边过来，就是有长江的支流的这种山涧溪流的环境，有长江边上的这种湖泊的环境，然后我们有河口的这种滩涂的这个栖息地。那么，然后这里呢，就到我们近海
入海了。
近海呢，就是说这个像我们江浙的沿海啊，对吧？
This has been a journey from the top of the Yangtze all the way to along the river basin, all the way to the ocean. So the banks of the Yangtze, and this all the display is the different wildlife. And obviously in the Yangtze, there's I think Director Zheng said there's about 400 types of fish, and this is only a very small amount of species that we see here.
然后这个呢，就是我们属于是，离开了我们近岸，对吧？到了我们的这个沿郊区了，就是海洋的这个沿郊区。那么这是一种海水。
这种鱼的名字是什么呢？
这个我们叫金钱鱼。
金钱鱼，
金钱豹是吗？
对，你看它身上一个小圆片。
We used to have the ancient age trying to have the money, just like those
the bronze little copper coins.
这个就是藏在这个沙里面呢，就是我们的河豚。
Where? Oh, this one.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh, I can't even see it.
It's like a camouflage.
So that's a puffer. That's a puffer fish.
Yeah.
就是是会鼓起来的。
对对对，就是河豚。
So don't anger it because it will blow up like a balloon. Oh, camera's trying.
But it's hiding itself with the sand.
它就把自己，它有一个习惯，它就是，活动一段时间之后，它会休息，那么它就会把自己埋在这个沙子里面。
So the puffer fish is resting. And also, I think the last tank is something very special.
You don't see that often.
I see it in the Jurassic Park movies, maybe. But
not
in real
life. I
don't know if our viewers have seen these before.
In Chinese, we call it ho. But do you know the English name for this?
Horseshoe crabs. Horseshoe crabs, because they look like horseshoe. So they have a very hard back. But this is...这个肯定是这有点活化石的感觉了。
对，这个它的历史比中华鲟还要久。
Longer,
它应该是有四亿年以上的历史。
Chinese sturgeons
400 million years ago they've been alive。因为我们看到有一些化石，其实真的就是长这个样子。
对，它很几乎就是目前您看到的它这个形态，跟它原始出现的那个时候几乎没有太大的差别。
They existed on this earth.Long before us. So we need. Even the fossils that we found, they basically underwent very little change since 400 million years ago. So these are actual living fossils.
Oh, the blood. Its blood is blue.
Blue blood. Real royalty. Blue blood. 那是为什么呢？
这实际上它的血液里面含有铜离子。
有铜。
我们人的话是铁离子。就是血红素嘛，血红蛋白，它是属于血蓝蛋白。
So it's to do with all the chemicals inside the bloodstream. And also we're just heading now to, because this is obviously a working conservation and a working research center, so they also undergo a lot of checks on these sturgeons to make sure that they're safe. 所以我们是不是从这块？
我们现在进入我们的
工作区。
starfish.
Only with the CGTN. We'll be show you the staff only areas.
So you have to be a bit quiet.
Now we see the top.
So this is the top of the
fish tank. Yes. Now we're in the front, through the glass, seeing the Zhonghuang fish. Now we're in the work area.
They look even bigger than we saw through the glass.
It feels like we're looking at the other
side. Yes, because that glass has a different shape. So we'll see the fish.
So from here we see like these fish.
你现在看到我说它有三米,
bigger.
你应该相信了。
Yeah. 那肯定是。 And from outside, because of the glass, so of the distortions, they might look a bit smaller, but up here they're definitely huge creatures of the Yangtze River.
If we dive into them, oh no, we piss them off. They're probably going to slap us away with
probably,
this tail.
Probably wouldn't try. I'm more worried that I might hurt the fish or they might hurt us.
Because they are very strong, right? If... The fish, actually, when it swims, it's very strong. Very strong.
So even we see now they're very gentle creatures and it's very slow. It's like a straw in the sea, but when they kind of struggle and when they really go for it, it could be deadly.
Because its tail, if it moves, because it has a spine, it can break people's legs.
They can break out our bones.
Oh gosh. Okay,
so no, okay, let me be like stay away from that.
Okay.
So because
you
see those structure
the crane like mechanics. So
saw some of the fish, they have the little stick on their back, it's the tracker, so they will know like this fish's name and its information, how long it's been here, the all this key information to save them. One of their key jobs to do is to regular thing they do is to do a health check with all these Chinese sturgeons to make sure they are healthy all these years. And now maybe we will soon see them doing the health check.
Help maybe to check up on the sturgeons as well.
So they're
preparing all the equipment that they need for the health check.
然后这边的话, 这个是我们专门为中华鲟抢救设计的一个抢救的一个手术工作台。
很大, 真的很大。 So this is an operating table for the surgeon, so we can see how long and how big it is to fit a single sturgeon on this operating table.
因为我们这个地方有好几个功能，一个是大型的中华鲟，我们可以给它做这个野外湖发生的这个湖做给它解剖采样。那么小的中华鲟的话，我们可以在这里通过不同的分割，给它区分它的受伤的程度。那么受伤的程度呢，然后再给它转移到我们的治疗池里去，就属于我们叫。 按照它的受伤程度进行分级分类的这个治疗，然后还有这个功能台上面呢，就是我们上面有这个测量的这个刻度尺，那么可以在这里做这个科学的一些数据的采集，包括它的这个采样啊，都是可以操作的。So
on this table, they will basically measure the criticalness of the injuries of these sturgeons that are basically unfortunate enough to be on this operating table. And then they can operate on large sturgeons, and also these departments can be divided for smaller sturgeons.
我很好奇，就是那我们救回来的这些中华鲟，他们那就是比较普遍的一些受伤啊，或者容易得的病都是什么呢？
一个就是它在。 前期的话，因为被网具啊等等这个捕捞之后呢，它主体就是一些体外的损伤。 体外的损伤，比如说这个刮伤啊，包括可能这个骨板的脱落呀。
So let's make way for the track table. Yeah, so a lot of these injuries are external injuries that they find outside.
Yeah. 现在我们的工作人员就是已经
马上就可以开始做体检了，是不是？这些呢，是我们就是说，一个是有这个幼鱼抢救的时候，它就是一个抢救后的一个治疗和观察池。就是放进去。对对对。那么在没有抢救的时候呢，它是作为我们一个科学实验池。那么可以开展一些这个养殖呀等等这个科学的这个实验。It's
kind of like the ICU room for fish. When you rescue someone, they are critically ill, you isolate them in this tank, and you can constantly observe how are they, are they getting well? So yeah, ICU rooms,
so the isolated. So the essence. Oh, so we can see here, there's a lot of people in orange. So, 我们穿橘色人都是工作人员，现在是要把我们鲟鱼先检查。So we're doing the operation. No. Not the operation, sorry, we're doing the
chasing the cameraman, so I was chasing the camera.
You're too eager to go and see the surgeons.
就是我们的鱼池里面下面的话，这个您看到的这个黑黝黝的，这个这都是中华鲟，看到吗？黑黝黝的。对对，你看。哦，那这个是一个什么池？这个带有多少个鲟在这里？这个是我们养这个中华鲟一个青鱼池。
就青鱼池，就是准备养殖之后作为我们的基本做人工繁殖使用。那个有涌浪镜呢，就是一个放流的驯化。驯化。
So
we have the training tank, we have the isolation tank.
每个池子都有它的这个不同的这个功能啊，你看它的近距离。那像这个池子一般会放几只鲟？像这个池子的话，我们大概基本上就是在 40到50尾。
40到50尾。哦，所以这是40到50尾。对，40到50尾。因为我们可以往上看，因为我知道，其实刚才一开始你也提到过，其实全世界的这个鲟鱼都是处于一种被保护的濒危的一个状态。全世界有多少种鲟？哦，这个是小的。对，这个是小的中华鲟。对对对。全世界的鲟鱼目前的话，大概是有27种。
27 different kinds of sturgeons all around the world, and they are all kind of endangered, protected animals.
Under protection.
然后我们国家长江里面呢有三种鲟鱼。
So in the Yangtze alone, there's 3 types of sturgeons just in our Yangtze River.
那什么原因导致鲟鱼其实比较容易濒危呢？它这个呢，其实有多种多样的因素。当然，人类活动的这个强度的加大。 人口的这个扩张等等，就是它这种因素呢，就是对环境的改变啊，那么它会比较明显，对吧？当然还有一个整体的全球气候的变化呀，水污染呀，等等，还有一些这个捕捞呀，捕捞的损伤啊，就我们说的这个有鱼受伤，对吧？这都是因为捕捞啊，什么之类的，等等。
So basically, all the sturgeons in the world were kind of endangered because of the overall activities of humans.
Exactly, overfishing, the environment, the climate, and also
water activities, expansion of the
cities, and pollution, which caused basically these majestic creatures to be now critically endangered. And it's quite sad, really.
Yeah.
So that's
because they survived 140 million years.
We won't let them distinct because of us.
Okay, they're ready for us, guys. This is definitely, is this your first time?
Wow.
Do a health check on a surgeon. It is for me.
It is my first time. We have some nurses.
这里呢是准备给中华鲟就是采集这个血样之后，做它的这个血细胞的检测。 啊，那做血图片的。 就类似于我们人去医院做体检，你有几项东西，一个叫血常规
啊，
一个叫血液生化里面叫肝功能、肾功能啊。
So it's like when we go get our health check, they just check our blood sugar level.
I just did mine in July.
Are you healthy?
Yeah, I'm very healthy. But I can relate to this surgeon right now.
然后那边呢，就是我们去医院做 B 超。
B 超，
so this is ultrasound.
现在是在做这个基础生长测量。那我们需要先测这个身高、
so now we have a height measurement and also a weight.
This is very much like how we
get our health check, annual health check.
113.
213.
他们需要什么有就是打就是让他们能他们不需要打麻药他们就是随着你这个工作的这个经验来讲可以通过简单的处理就让他相对来说比较安静。
So those people are very experienced, so they don't need
sedations,
extra medicine to control the animals. So
最主要的是我们要把这个给鱼做检查的整个工作流程要科学化，要规范化，
standardized,
最短的时间里面完成对它的检查，
process,
尽可能减少对它的这个应激的影响。
Exactly. To,
they have to carry away. This
is
the
So very strict regulations to ensure that they do, they pose as little damage to the fish as possible.
我们说多长时间会给中华鲟做一次体检？
我们一般的话，每年的话大概一到两次。
每年 one or twice every year.
所有的我们登记在册的中华鲟都会做一遍体检。
我们现在有大概多少只？多少尾？
我们大概500多尾。
Wow, so right now there's about 500 Chinese sturgeons in this research.
每一只都要做体检。那其实他们在池子里长得都一样，你们每次怎么能保证我不是一直捡的是同一个？
因为我们的每一尾中华鲟它都有它的这个身份。我们给它植入了一个米粒大小的一个芯片。
米粒大小，所以they have
大概是10到12毫米的。
So there's a 10 to 12 millimeter, right, basically like a grain of rice, and that's the ID tag inside their body.
然后用我们的专用的这个扫描仪就可以把它扫出来。
We can see that, so 那个是在做。
对，那现在已经在做给它做 B 超的检查了。
所以这个是看它哪一个部位。它的。So we're just looking at its maturity, how it's maturing right now.
我们现在看到这个是什么呢？
性腺，就发育的。So now we are seeing on the camera, like these are the intestines, and these are the like genitals.
So it's just seeing how mature it's becoming, basically.
Yeah. Are they ready to reproduce?
大概多少岁？
这个鱼应该也有这个15岁以上了。
This particular Chinese sturgeon is about 15 years old. 所以刚才是21岁的，是3米多，所以这个还一直在长。
对，它一直长。鱼的话呢，它终身都在生长，啊，它不像人，人长到一定程度只会萎缩。鱼的话，它是终身生长。
等到
它成熟之后，它的生长就会慢一些。
So with fish, they grow continuously with age. So unlike human, we probably stop growing at a certain age, but with fish, they keep going until they're basically too old. This process will take about how long?
你说这个体检？
对，体检过程。
体检我们一般控制在10到15分钟。
So they'll control the health check within 10 to 15 minutes.
测量、采样、做 B 超，那么我们是从它出离开了水开始计算这个时间。
So it's when they leave the water to when they're put back in the water, so they have to keep it in a strict 10 to 15 minutes.
当然，我们为了保证它的这个舒适性的话，包括它出来之后，它也不是完全离水，我们会有一个它检查的一个水槽。对，里面通过蒸氧啊什么之类的。那么它实际上绝对离水的时间，就是从鱼池到这个水槽的这个时间，可能也就是个十几秒的时间。
Only just around 10 seconds that without water.
没有控制这个时间。扫描仪扫一下。这就是我们扫描仪。
So this is a tag. I don't know if you can see.
I can see,
I should show the camera. So this is the data on the ID tag.
Mm-hmm.
So this is in our system. It's
just its
ID number of the sturgeon.
So it's an ID or passport.
That's how to make sure they can check every sturgeon.
可以跟踪它从小到现在每一年的生长的这个情况。
So they can track every year. 那他们如果再回到海里以后，我们还能跟踪到吗？
海里之后的话，我们就不能够持续的跟踪了。 因为它这是一个被动的一个芯片，所以我们扫描仪才能扫。比较困难，就是到海里以后去看它的一个时限。
So once they're released in the ocean, it's very hard to track them, and that's I think one of the challenges of trying to revive these ancient creatures.
谢谢。 Because all my shoes are wet because I was basically step in the water. So they're so kind, bring me a towel.
So this is all we have from the Chinese sturgeons. It's been definitely been an experience for me.
Also, it's quite an experience for me as well, especially like we mentioned earlier, we saw firsthand in the ocean, not just sturgeons, all kinds of marine animals, corals. They were so endangered because of us, because of our behavior. So I think it's also our responsibility to protect them, make sure we can all harmoniously coexist with each other.
Exactly. And I think Director Chen was saying before that these fish have existed for 140 million years. And the fact that they are becoming critically endangered, or maybe to a certain point in the future, maybe if they become extinct, it's really the human activity that's really caused this change. So I hope that with tides of change, and also we have this third season coming up as well, that we learn to really respect the environment that we live in, respect the ocean, respect everything around us, and maybe we can leave something for the future generations.
Yeah. So thank you so much for staying with us, Tides of Change. This is our last stop
in Shanghai.
We have more shows tomorrow. Stay tuned. But for now, we're gonna say goodbye.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Bye. 谢谢，谢谢，
谢谢同学。